Hello, welcome to NetVN. In this video I show how to build cloud storage on Windows 11 with VMware. I use Nextcloud to create cloud storage. Normally to install and configure Nextcloud we use a lot of commands, so it's a bit difficult to do. To simplify cloud hosting I use an image file called dietpy. Dietpy can be installed on many different platforms from hardware to virtualization. You go to Dietpy homepage and download the image file for VMware Hypervisor. This is a compressed file so you use software called 7-zip to decompress it. I create a new folder called VM in the C partition of my Windows 11 computer and store the image file after extracting. Next you open the VMware Hypervisor and create a new virtual machine by opening the extracted image file. You rename this virtual machine as you like. As you can see, you get a new virtual machine without installing an operating system. Next you start the virtual machine. Here is the information about the virtual machine, including the IP address, username and password. Default username is root, default password is dietpy. With the first login dietpy automatically updates to the new version. Then you are asked to set the keyboard style. To access the cloud host I will forward the port on the router so I set up a static IP address for this virtual machine. You set up the IP address, gateway and DNS for this virtual machine. Then apply the changes and return to the main screen. As mentioned, to build my personal cloud storage I use Nextcloud. So you search for software called Nextcloud and install it. This Nextcloud installation is much simpler than using the command line. Now on Windows 11 you open any browser to access the Nextcloud server using the IP address of the virtual machine. Default username is admin. Default password is dietpy. So the Nextcloud server has been created, but we configure it so that it has a larger capacity and can be accessed from outside the internet. By default, the storage capacity of this cloud is less than 10 GB, too small. In this part I configure to increase the storage capacity of the Nextcloud server. I shut down this virtual machine using the command power off. Next shut down Windows 11 computer. Here I have a hard drive with a capacity of 1 terabytes. I connect it to the target computer. I will increase my cloud server storage by adding this hard drive. On your Windows 11 computer, check to see if it has detected the added hard drive. As you can see, Windows 11 has detected the newly added hard drive. To add a physical hard drive to a virtual machine on VMware, you must open this software with administrative rights. You choose the next cloud server and add a new hard drive. In this virtual machine you add a new physical hard drive using the SATA interface. On this computer there are two physical hard drives identified as 0 and 1. A traditional hard drive with a capacity of 1 terabytes is identified as a physical hard drive 1. Our virtual machine has added a physical hard drive with a capacity of 1 terabytes. So how do you add it to Nextcloud server? You start the virtual machine and follow these steps. You access the BIOS of the virtual machine and set it to boot from the hard drive running DietPi. You save the changes and start the virtual machine. I recommend you to access the Nextcloud virtual machine using SSH for easier copying of commands. You open a command window on Windows 11 and use the SSH command to remotely access the Nextcloud virtual machine. Remote access to virtual machine with username as root, default password as DietPi. You use the lsblk command to display the list of drives on the virtual machine. SDB is a traditional drive with a capacity of 1 terabytes. Before adding it to the Nextcloud server, delete all the partitions on this hard drive. You use the fdisk command to delete the partition. If there are multiple partitions on your hard drive, repeat the steps to delete the partitions one after another. After deleting all partitions, you create a new partition on this hard drive. You use the W key to save the changes. After completing the creation of the new partition, format it using the command called mkfs. The partition named SDB1 is formatted as ext4. Next, you create a new directory named disk2 using the command named mkdir. You mount the newly created folder with a 1 TB hard drive. After mounting, you use the lsblk command to check the result. Mounted, everything is fine. Now open a web browser and enable Nextcloud server access and follow these steps. By default, Nextcloud does not allow connection to external storage. You access the application settings on Nextcloud. Here you enable the use of external storage. You will be asked for a password to activate this app. Default password is DietPi. This is the hard drive that I want to add to the Nextcloud server storage system. To add it to Nextcloud storage, follow these steps. External storage local. Configuration /mnt/disk2. You name the folder as you like. Then save your changes. You should see a folder named disk2 appear. Next, I upload a random file to test. Upload failed, something is wrong. That's right, because I haven't set permissions for this folder. So I went back to the command prompt and used the following two commands to set permissions for the folder named disk2. With these two commands, will it help me to upload successfully? Please wait and see. Again, I upload any file. I upload successfully, so I have increased the storage for Nextcloud server. You repeat the above steps to add as many hard drives as you want. But this Nextcloud server is only accessible in local network. Do you want it to access remotely over internet? If you want, you to follow these steps. You go to your router's management page and set up port forwarding. This is my router management page. You forward ports 443 and 80 to the Nextcloud server's IP address, respectively. In this case, the IP address of the Nextcloud server is 192.168.11.4. Each type of router has a different configuration. The forwarding method on your router will be different, but the purpose of port forwarding is the same. The port forwarding configuration on the router is complete. With this configuration, you can access Nextcloud server from internet using public IP address. But most of us use dynamic public IP address, so I recommend dynamic DNS service called DuckDNS to solve this problem. DuckDNS will give you 5 free domains. Then I will introduce how to update the public IP address. Here I use Google account to log in DuckDNS. Then I created a new domain name for free. Next, follow the instructions to update your public IP address. Your public IP address will be assigned with the domain name. Every 5 minutes your IP address will be checked and mapped with your domain name. This will solve your dynamic public IP address problem. On the Nextcloud server, you create a new folder named DuckDNS. In this directory, you create a new file named duck.sh. Then you open the file called duck.sh and paste the code containing the domain name and token. Next, you schedule to update the address every 5 minutes. You run the executable called duck.sh to check the results. If you get the result as OK, then you are successful. I get OK result, so I have successfully configured DuckDNS on Nextcloud server. Now you can access cloud hosting over internet using domain name. But I recommend that you encrypt your data when transmitting it over the internet. So you use the command dietpy software to find and install the software called Let's Encrypt. This software helps you to encrypt data when transmitting over the internet using HTTPS. Let's Encrypt installation is complete. Next, you use the command dietpy launcher and configure Let's Encrypt. You scroll down and search for Let's Encrypt. Here you enter your domain name. Automatically redirect from HTTP to HTTPS. You apply the settings and start configuring Let's Encrypt. You receive a congratulatory message like this as success. You close the configuration window. Thus, I have completed the introduction of the steps to build a cloud storage server with VMware. Next, I will check the results by using a smartphone connected to the cloud server over the internet. On smartphones, you download and install the Nextcloud app from Apple Store or Play Store. You then connect to the cloud hosting server using the domain name set up in the previous step. You use HTTPS to encrypt the transmission. Default username is root. Default password is dietpy. I recommend that you change the default password to ensure your data safety. Connection is successful. I will upload any file to test. I upload this file to a folder called Disk 2. It will be stored on the 1 TB hard drive I mentioned in the previous step. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and help me 600,000 subscribers. Good luck. File upload is successful. With just one Windows 11 computer, you can create your own cloud server with the capacity you want.